Hi friends. So today we are going to see the history of C++. The languages before C++, you know, let's just see what all languages were present before, like, this is like a prelude. So firstly, there was a language called CPL, which was introduced from the University of Cambridge in the 1960s. Then after that, BCPL was introduced, and from BCPL, B was introduced. After which, C was introduced, and from that was the evolution of C++. So C++ as a language was not introduced in the beginning itself. It was introduced as C with objects. And this was back in 1983, which was the year we won the first World Cup. So after that, Microsoft standardized the language, and that's how the story goes. Now, if we were to look at the overall language history, the first three which were introduced were COBOL, Fortran, and Lisp. And from these three, ALGOL and Simula had evolved. And from this came BCPL. And from BCPL came Classic C. So keep this hierarchy in mind. And Classic C is the reason why C was introduced. Now, from C came C89. And then next came C++. And apart from these, many languages were introduced from Lisp and Fortran. From C++, what had evolved next was Java. So in C++, there are many codes where we have to go through hard work and memory handling. So to simplify that and to give portability and for few topics to adapt, and that is why Java was introduced. And then different versions came. And the derived version of Java was C#. It has even roots from C++ as well. So if we learn C++, then Java, C, and C# can be easily understood. But there are no rules on going from one chapter to another, like in school. You can read everything on its own as well. So now, C++ 11 has been evolved. So this is the overall history, 98, C++, Java, C#, and then C++ 11. So what is C++? It is a general purpose programming language. It's a middle level language, which means you can use low level codes, like assembly level codes, or even high level codes, like the English language, add, and so on. So why do we need this? To write programs more comprehensive, to define a code clearly is the main goal. Before this, it wasn't clear. But in C++, we can bring in the OPS concept where we can segregate the codes appropriately and keep it as modules. Modules are basically group of functions which we can assign a name. Variables, without keeping it as a global, if in these 10 functions it has to be accessible, we assign a name and keep it. And local data is where it's confined to its own block. So the primary goal of object orientation is that it tries to emulate the real world objects. For example, people like us who move. But for this, we have data function. So like height, weight, color, all these are data and functions are how we would behave. So combining all this, we can bring it as an object or a thing, which is the principle. So functions which have to be performed on the object are called object functions. Like the functions which you need access to are called object functions. So there's a famous quote by this personality. Earlier, the bubble slide I had to use, it is with his permission actually. So what he states is that one, people complain, and the other, no one uses. Like languages such as C, Java, C++, even though we complain, we use it. There are other sophisticated languages which people don't tend to use for their application. So this is the evolution of C++. And so thank you, friends, and see you in the next video.